I love it because we just ended one of someone that I've supported was telling us a little bit about his experience of being able he spent most of his life really not able to express his emotions. And to be able to express our emotions, y'all, like is the most important part of being a human. Because when we keep this stuff locked up and inside of us, then that's where the trauma builds up. That's where all of that emotional pain builds up. And that's when we explode or we start using substances or something outside of ourselves to cope with those feelings that just feel like too much. So being able to emote in a healthy way is what we all really crave. And the nervous system transformation that I support people to experience is about going to that root cause, like really figuring out like what was it? What was that original incident that shocked you, that shocked your nervous system, and had you have to fragment or had to develop behaviors just to keep yourself alive? And so often, especially with men, we're taught, and I was raised by men, so we're taught not to cry, you know? So
Yes,
men are taught not to
correct.
cry, women are taught not to cry. You know, so many of us are taught that it is unsafe to cry. And so what I really guide people through is how to feel safe. And safety, the coolest part about it is that safety starts in the relationship that we have with one another. So I am, you know, I call it like I hold a very safe container where in which someone can feel safe enough to relax and then to be able to start to emote what they haven't been able to emote, right? And we do this, like trauma healing is all about taking aligned action. Taking aligned action. And until we can actually feel safe enough, we will not take that aligned action, right? Because the nervous system, again, that path of least resistance will not allow us to go to places that are unknown because it's scary, right? And so the nervous system's like, no, we just gonna drink a cup of coffee and we just gonna drink some alcohol. We're just gonna do the thing
Right.
that's done.
We good. Right. We're gonna shoot up some heroin. We're gonna go just go
Yeah,
watch
and
porn.
people
We're
think
just
like,
gonna.
oh my gosh, how can they do
We're
that?
gonna. We're gonna beat our wife. We're gonna. Right.
Exactly. But, you know, in my opinion, I have so much compassion for the person that beats their wife, and I have so much compassion for the person who, you know, is breastfeeding their baby alcohol, and who is, I mean, even though they're hurting someone else, like they're hurt, right? And in order to have a transformation in their life, they've got original incidents that really need to be healed. And, you know, and so many of us just unconsciously, like Lisa's sharing, are taught that it's not safe, right? And maybe it was never told to you directly, but emotional trauma is so insidious. Emotional
Yes.
trauma is,
For
yeah.
example, I just want to so because a lot of people are not going to know this. So I'm just going to read what Lisa put here that Amy is addressing and using as an example is Lisa puts in Lisa is at balance within the chaos. Lisa writes on the screen, "I was raised by an army colonel who also taught me it's bad to cry." And so that's what Amy is addressing here. Go ahead about how insidious certain things can be. Go ahead.
Right. Well, you know, I mean, we've thought of in our lifetime that trauma means like a big trauma, like war or getting into a really bad car accident or something that's very physical. And what we now know without any kind of doubt that the science proves it, that the emotional trauma can be the most complex trauma because it happened over and over and over again. And as we grow up, then we unconsciously invite those same situations, those same type of people into our life. And we relive that kind of energy that was never really good for us, that was keeping us small, that was contracting us, that was causing us to not feel our best, right? Then we continue to have those patterns throughout our life. So I support people to really understand their attachment system, to understand their nervous system, and therefore we can have a whole life transformation and, you know, ultimately a nervous system transformation. And, you know, the cool thing about what I'm doing on Saturday is I just completed our first session of sober relationship school, and it was such a success. Like what happened in 4 weeks for the people that really played full out was incredible, mind-blowing, just amazing. It was so awesome to
Awesome.
witness. Yeah. And so Saturday, what I'm doing is I'm putting together a workshop so people can really get to know me. It's totally complimentary. We'll spend about 75 minutes together. I'm doing it on Zoom so we can all see one another's faces and be interactive with one another. Okay. I really feel like it's important that when people commit to themselves and say yes to themselves, that they understand who they're saying yes to themselves, and I will be their guide. Sure. I will be their guide. However, like, I am a guide, right? I'm not someone who comes in and tells people what to do, because the most important thing about the relationship with working with me is that you feel safe. That you feel safe at all times. And the only way that I can push on the nervous system and support people to actually change is if they feel safe.